Hi everybody, Miss Melinda here, your spiritual worker from Miss Melinda's Metaphysical Services.com, here to bring you video number 4 in our series on ancestor veneration, coming from a universalist perspective and designed to give you everything that you need to begin your relationship with your ancestors from scratch. If you haven't watched videos 1 through 3, it's important that you go back and see that foundational information. Here in video number 4, we're going to talk about day-to-day veneration, what your daily actions look like in conjunction with your ancestor practice and tending your ancestor altar. So the first thing that's really important is for you to set up a schedule and commit to it. You're making a commitment to yourself, to your own spiritual development, and you're making a commitment to your ancestors. You're letting them know when you will be available for them. This is really important because it's like setting up office hours. It's letting them know when you're open for business, when you're open to communicate, when you're open to receive messages, when you're open to interact with them. Establishing consistency in this practice is going to assist you with furthering this practice a lot more quickly, with taking it to the next level a lot more quickly. So your day-to-day actions are going to include tending the altar. If you can do this every day, that's the best course to take. However, it's really important that you commit to something that works well for you. So if you can only commit to this once a week and you know that you can stick to it once a week, then commit to it once a week. The important thing is consistency, that you stick with it, that you continue to cultivate the dedication, that you continue to remain patient, and that you are dedicated to these actions that your ancestors and yourself understand that you're dedicated to developing and furthering this relationship and this connection. If you're going to commit to tending your ancestor altar once a week, then Sundays are the perfect day for it, if that works with your schedule. And what you want to do when you tend your altar is make sure that it's neat and clean. This could mean washing the cloth if it has the white cloth on it, cleansing the space, spiritually cleansing the space, setting out fresh offerings. It's really better if you can set out fresh water every day, but if you can't, at least set out fresh water every week. This may mean changing out the flowers. If you've decided to do level 2 of the basic offerings, which would include incense, flowers, and black coffee, then you may need to refresh or change out the flowers weekly. You're going to want to make sure that you have a candle available, so you may need to replace the white candle on a weekly basis as well. As far as your day-to-day practice at your ancestor altar is concerned, here is a summary of what we have spoken about before. First, you're going to give them prayers of honor, prayers of gratitude. You're going to venerate them, thank them for all they've done for you so far and all they will do in the future. Thank them for everything they've done before you. Things known and unknown, things seen and unseen, all the ways that they've affected who you are as a person, all of the challenges and obstacles that they have worked through before you, everything that they've taken care of before you came into this plane, and them making it possible for you to come into this plane in the first place. Thank them for being present in creating this relationship for you. Thank them in advance, even if they haven't already made themselves clear or made themselves known to you. Thank them for hearing your prayers, for hearing your gratitude. Ask them to accept these humble offerings. Let them know that you come to them with pure intentions. Keep that pure intention at the forefront of your mind, at the forefront of your purpose in this relationship. Let them know that you want to enter a relationship with which is mutually beneficial for the purpose of spiritual evolution. Let them know in so many ways that you understand this is a reciprocal relationship, that they are not only here to help you, that you are also there to help them. Ask them to send you signs, guidance, and messages indicating what they need from you, either physically in terms of the altar, what they need to be comfortable, what they need perhaps physically in your home, or what they need from you as a person in order to continue to develop, strengthen, and deepen this relationship. Let them know your sincere desires to deepen this relationship, that it's important to you, that you're dedicated to it, that you're making it a priority in your life. Ask them to make themselves known to you. Ask them to be present in your life, to send them signs, to send you signs, guidance, and messages in a way that you can understand on the human plane and in a way that you as an individual can understand. And then you're going to need to make space in your life to pay attention to those signs, to be open to those signs, to be receptive to those signs, to take pause in your daily life when you maybe do receive a sign or a message, to interpret it, to contemplate it, and to actually take action on it and to figure out how to integrate that guidance into your life, how to take action on it. Keep in mind that you are venerating your ancestors. You are not worshiping your ancestors. It is very unlikely for most of us to be related to a spirit who has become a god or who was previously a god or a deity. Right? So we are venerating our ancestors. We're entering a relationship with them. We are not worshiping them as gods or deities. This distinction is important. These are acts of veneration. These are acts of honor. These are acts of gratitude. Even if they are becoming evolved spirits, even if they have become exceptionally evolved spirits, that doesn't mean that they are a god or a deity. That is something that would be extremely rare. Keep in mind that your relationship with your ancestors is going to change over time. So a lot of what you're going to be doing in the beginning, this can take up to 6 months to a year. It's going to require you to have patience, commitment, and dedication. And a lot of what you're doing here is asking to deepen the relationship, showing them your commitment, showing them your consistency, and asking to deepen, develop, and grow the relationship, asking for them to give you signs, asking for them to come to you, asking for them to be present in your life, and offering them gratitude, offering them illumination, offering them clarity, right? The fire and the water, offering them your thanks, your reverence, your respect, letting them know that you come from a place of humility with pure intentions. These are the things that you're going to be working on within yourself and with them until a main ancestor or more than one main ancestor makes themselves apparent to you. At that time, your practice will begin to change and evolve and it will look differently. But in the beginning, it's really important you keep these key concepts in mind, you keep yourself protected, you stay patient, consistent, and dedicated. Stay tuned for episode number 5, and stay blessed.